Maybe not so many people interested in programmable array logic. Let's see what we got here for our 84,000. So this might wait for Vsync R, and no, still flickers. So either the wait doesn't work or in general there's something wrong with my cursor setting. But you see in general this is doing more useful stuff now. This full screen is cut like this. Oh, wait a second. Why does this make... sense? So as you see, this cursor just still flickers just like the other day. And I thought maybe waiting for vertical resync, vertical retrace helps, but either we have... oh, wait a second. Did I invert this? Value of 0 indicates video data is being displayed, while not indicates vertical retrace interval during vertical sync pulls. So I inverted this, huh? While not so much to live testing and coding and watching more to the OBS output than what we are doing here. So the point of this is to teach programming and various electronic stuff and eventually collect more code. As I said, I wanted a ISA accelerator, PCI accelerator and 3D stuff. The verge we have done already, and I just wanted to get this newly purchased from eBay ET4000, do some acceleration. And the good news is we made some progress here with that. The bad news is not yet enough. Evening, Christian. So, also need to load a keyboard driver another day. So ET4K, let's see if this inversion did the trick. So yes, this fixed this. So you should probably not touch this cursor registers during the vertical retrace. During actual other way around. So now the flickering is away. And if I'm lucky, I had this on the live stream or not. So this fixed this. We could also check two things. We could either try also if just, this is by the way the coffee machine suspending, which is still old coffee. Finishing daily work stuff and now my coffee is cold already. So this did the trick for this. We could try if just checking if we are currently displaying the CRTCB window, which is our sprite, or if horizontal display is horizontal retrace. Let's see if just CRTB window active is enough. So that is until not the same indicates. It's of course funny, they write here. Here they write 0 first, here they write 1 first, the wonders of hardware. Wait a second, what? Oh no, they don't write here, I mix this, they don't write here at all. Anyway, so indicates is active, indicates a vertical retrace interval during, indicates that the CRTB window is active, I hope. Wait a second, what does this indicates? video data is currently displayed. Indicates that CRTC bin is active within the current scanline. Oh, this is probably what I wanted, not this. What does this indicate then? I could also switch to actually this view for your viewing pleasure. This one. So maybe this only indicates if it's active at all, not if it's currently displayed. So this is then what I wanted. So then this is bit 6. While repeat, so then let's copy this. And then I say a word about programmable array logic. Wait. CRTB, and this is bit 6. So while bit 6. CRTB active. Using, let's see if this does something. Probably should reconfigure my monitor setup that I have this primary and secondary display more comfortable. Still using the CF card swap method, but another day I will try if this MTCP would work for me, because regarding this programmable array logic, I realized tinkering with this linear RAM buffer stuff that there is a PAL, a programmable array logic, on there on the address lines of the ISA bus. So I think there is hope to get this linear RAM buffer working, just that I have not yet got it to work. Also, this PAL thing makes it slightly more difficult to reverse engineer. I could unsolder this and probe there this input lines, but I don't really feel like unsoldering this on my new from eBay purchased VGA card. So ET4K 32. Let's see. Looks like this might be enough. It's for YouTube, and then everything takes 5 times as long. I think I have not switched over the function there. Wait, 30B. So yeah, still tinkering with this vintage stuff. I hope you like it. And so programmable array logic is here some data sheet. So what this does is you can program this. It's actually the early form of FPGAs, I would say. So this programmable array logic devices feature high speed and a choice of either standard or low power devices. And it's from the 80s, obviously, in 1984, and revised in 1992. And what this does is this has some huge array of fuses in there and 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 OR logic. So you have here some huge field of, in this form, 2000 something, 48 or so, I guess, fuses. And when you program this, those fuses are burned so that you program your logic that you wanted to achieve there. So here are the input pins, and the output pins of those are here. And then by burning those fuses, you program the logic you wanted to program. And one of those programmable array logic integrated circuits is used there on the address lines, on the high address lines on the ISA bus. And I show you this in a second. I take the card out. Let's just test my cursor again, ET4K. So, okay, this is not enough. So then we should probably, I only wonder that this usually works if you program a higher address, but So this is active while this is active, I think it should work. CRTB active. Bit 6, value of 1 indicates that the CRTCB window is active within the current scan line. Within the current scan line. Okay, fine, then let's do vSync for now. We don't update the cursor so often anyway. And until we find some vSync. So now I need to be careful not to destroy here this nice card. Taking it out with power on. So this W, I showed this yesterday already, that we have here this strange address decoding here, because what we want to do historically, the frame buffer of VGA is accessed, so this is power off, is at the 64K segment A0000. And this is of course not very comfortable for programming, especially if you're used to modern programming, because you can only address 64K at a time. Of course not very convenient that you constantly need to, when you fill this frame buffer, you constantly need to watch what you are filling and where. And you need, if you cross this window border, you need to switch this bank and window that you are displaying. So now let's, so the problem with this is that this stand is not as comfortable as I would want. That comes from reusing. Reusing monitor stands that you have standing around here. Hope this is in focus. So maybe we try to make this even larger. I hope this is visible after switching the camera. So here we have our beautiful vintage card. I hope it's sharp enough. And what we have here is, let's switch to, do I still have this here somewhere? ISA Wikipedia. So the ISA bus is, was initially an 8-bit bus. This part is the 8-bit bus part here, and then later extended to 16-bit. So the 16-bit address lines are on this part. And let's look up here the pin layout from Wikipedia. And here we have the pinout. You see 8-bit XT bus and 16-bit AT bus, and we have the address lines here. Address line, you see a 23, 22. I hope it's visible on the live stream. And I took a look on this today because I really want this linear frame buffer to work. And when you look closely, maybe I need to zoom in even more. Oh, did I not switch? I really need a better hotkey that works system-wide here. And how many drop frames? Zero drop frames. So let me zoom this in even more. Still need to... I already got here new monitor stand stuff, but still not awesome enough. By the way, maybe I should have, because now the weight of the camera arm gets a little bit hefty. Let's see if this works. So I hope you might see this here, that the address lines that I just showed you here, this is 23, address line 23, 22, and so on, and until the 17th is here. So all these address lines, so this is something else, this is SH, HE, whatever this is. So this address lines 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, they all go here. And when we measure, by the way, if video or audio is not good enough, let me know. And when we measure this, they go to this integrated circuit here. Let's see, this one was here. So here. And 23 goes, okay, to pin 1. So you see all those address lines go straight here to this integrated circuit. And what they could do with this, because yesterday I said normally you would map this into this ISA 15 megabyte ISA hole. However, as I showed yesterday, this card does not have enough bits to compare this. So this, no, this is what I sort that this is moving with such a heavy weight here. This comes from using not professional enough hardware. So when we take a look, what is this? And I hope I don't destroy my precious card here with this. This is a PAL. PAL 16L8 ACN. And I think this was what I had online there on my screen. So, more camera work, more problems of zooming to stuff. I hope you appreciate all this advanced camera work here. So as I said yesterday, oh no, not yesterday, today, so PAL, let's see, what did I look up here earlier? So as you see, I did not yet, because the problem is this is programmable with these fuses, so I don't know how many, what kind of programming they have done there. And I would hope they have mapped this, because with just the two bits here in the segment comparator, you can't map this to the 50 megabyte hole. I would hope that this Taiwanese company who designed this in 1991 or so mapped this to the 15 megabyte hole for linear frame buffer. But this is really difficult to find out. I tried this today already, to write there in all the memory and stuff and change the programming and everything, but it did not yet had any effect that I would see. So PAL 16L8, this is by the way R8, maybe Oh no, 16, what's 16? No, LA, ah, here are two. So this is 10 inputs and PAL16L8. Yeah, PAL16L8. So this is the first one, 10 inputs, three state outputs. And yeah, so much to that. So to figure out, you could solder this out and probe all the bit combinations there and see which one, what kind of logic function they programmed into there. But this is really slightly unfortunate that it is like this. But so what this means, I by the way have not measured. We could actually try to measure when we already have here this fancy measuring setup. We could actually try and measure, because I've not done this yet, to measure if this is going to this segment enable pin, which is here. By the way, you see that it's written that this is decoded as seg e enable and A22. So I would hope they use this PAL to, yeah, so this is pin 50 and pin 50. I only hope I don't electrocute here my precious card, you know, for this YouTube stream. And let's see, pin 50 would be, okay, this would be here, 51 is there. And if we count this, I hit here four. Did I put this away already? So 41, actually we could directly use this. The problem is, which is the output pin from this PAL, from this programmable array logic. They only write here, so 10 should be, so you see, if I switch the camera, as I said, this is this one, 10 inputs, so here are the 10 inputs from 1 to 11. Okay, this should, oh no, two outputs, so, ah, okay, so then it's one output is 19 and one is 12, and the other pins are, I think, for programming, I guess. So this should theoretically be pin 50. Let's try figure out if we can. Figure out if that is like this. So pin, by the way, do we see which one is connected? So this second pin is connected, pin 12 is connected, and actually this second pin is also connected. I think both pins are connected, at least the trace is going somewhere. And let's see. I see it already coming for this video. I static charge here this card. So this was pin 50 and this is pin 41. So 41, 2, really smallish, so 1, 1, 2, 3, really small though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One of those here, 41, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 50 should be that one. Let's see if it's going either there. Strange. So I think pin 50 is unfortunately not going to this output pins. That is unfortunate. Where did they connect this then? Then it is no wonder that this did not have any effect what I tried today. Welcome everyone who joined in the meantime. So pin 50. Here by the way the address line. So this is all these pins here are actually, as you can see, so pin 50, it's of course slightly, they wrote this here reverse, so 54 to 44, these are all address lines. So they go all down here. It's of course really a pity that you have documentation and you still need to trace your stuff like this. Maybe I should scan this and have a higher resolution image and do this here. I really wonder where these output pins go then, because this is a second. So this goes here to this wire. Don't tell me this is going to this next one here, or is it? This is that wire, so this is the output pin. And here's the trace, and here's the wire. And which of all of those are now this? This is under the integrated circuit there. It could be that this is actually this wire. No, it's not. So it might go to this. Yeah, you need to resolve to such measurements to figure out if this even has a chance to work. Really a pity. I wish it would just work. And then you need to reverse engineer your hardware just for that. So that wire and this other. So this output pin is going to that wire here. And where is that wire going to? That is this wire. This is mysterious. That wire is going to... This is, I think, some memory access rewrite, or what was this? This is memc or something, by the way, this is memcs16. What is that doing? Anyway, but then, okay, so then this is going there. Let's, by the way, maybe we measure this for real. Yep. So this output pin goes to that. This is mem. Maybe this is some acknowledge line. Mem CS16. Let's see, do we have... Yeah, Devin V. I wanted to get this teasing stuff working more than less, which it does not yet. So I was trying to figure out where those. So the thing is, as I said slightly earlier in this live stream, this card has 1 megabyte VRAM, and I would ideally want to address it in a linear fashion, which it currently does not do. Yeah, Christian, right. I tried to figure out, but so to really figure out, we would need to have this run with voltage, because this needs ground and VCC here, obviously, for those logic gates. And so, as I said earlier, I would need to desolder this, and I don't want to risk this. And yeah, so, but anyway, this one is going there. The only question is this should then go to some address input pin. This was the second. The second is this, and this goes to this wire, and that wire is under the IC. So, could it be that, but we could actually at least try, if it goes directly, this output pin to any of those address lines here. Only prob- hey, here it was. Can you believe it? Let's see if it goes to any of these other pins there. So it's not going to any of the high pins. So it's going there, apparently. But this will be a pain to count which one of those it is. Let's see if we can zoom in. So the problem is this is quite a bit away with this tripod. And I'm not sure if this will be the most sharp there. Maybe leave in the comments below how sharp this is for you to watch. So this is the output pin of this port. So the two output pins are this, this and this. So this is VCC, this is ground. These are the input pins, as well as this one, and these are the output pins, the second here, and the others are, I think, for programming, I/O. And so this output pin goes to the other side, to this memory address, acknowledge something or whatever. And this is going somewhere here, according to my measurement. This one. It makes sense. It looks to come down from here. So it from the other side, it goes over there to a via. This via are those going through the PCB to connect one side to another, or a layer in between. So this is this one. So this, what does this mean? The problem is without Lewis Rossmann's microscope, it's slightly difficult to count. So this is 40, 39, 8, 40, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 30, maybe it's 29, but it's slightly, it's always a risk to jump there one day, not one day, jump there. To jump there over one pin. So let's see what 29 could be. 29, where do I have my, did I know? Close accidentally my, download. So any questions from the audience? Let's see. Hi Ash. Welcome everyone. So pin 29, let's see, can we find it with my OCR document? Of course we will find 29 everywhere. Oh, maybe we should also switch to this view. Let's see, what is pin 29? The BIOS calls we're not interested in. I slightly wonder what they have done there with this. This is really. Should just continue pressing F3 to search from the top. Now we scrolled over so much that it also wasn't really faster. Come on, must be somewhere. Pin description here. What was it so? Early in the document. Here we go. So we were looking at around pin 29. Yes, Devin, I got the brown switches. 29, pin 25. Here is active low command pulse for IO write access. What are they doing with this? This is somehow not really fitting there. This is labeled 40, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, maybe it's 30. Does it make it better? Not really. That is MD active low. Oh no, for memory active low command pulse for memory read access. What have they done with this part there? Can I count them nicer from here? 40, this is this trace going down there. 49, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That is really a pity if they have done this some complete chaos. I wonder slightly, however, they have here higher address lines where they are going. They are all going down there. Maybe I should make a higher resolution scan, and because these are all the higher address lines and they go down here, then all of them to wires to the other side here, and then there. Really a pity. Maybe they have borked there something that this really doesn't work with whatever magic they have done there. So yeah, the fun toying with obsolete vintage retro stuff. I think another day we need to continue with something more modern. Let's hope we don't electrocute the card here with static discharges. Let's see what's going on in the chat. No, this board is not this port. This board is essentially the ET, the teasing. This huge IC in the middle there is the ET4000W32. This PAL is only on the ISA 16, higher 16-bit address line. So the good news is this card still works. The bad news is I'm less sure than before that this linear frame buffer stuff could work. Yeah. 84K W32. But the only good thing is we could continue with this less awesome banked memory, segmented memory stuff there. By the way, I hope I record. Do I record this? Yeah, looks like record is running. And yeah. So what I could show you, because the annoying thing of this is, without this linear address, we need to switch our windowed segment that we see in this regular VGA A0000, and I have code for this already. Tested just before the live stream, so I called this here VGA set page or segment or whatever. And that is this here. Because this means for all set page, because or even when we use this low resolution of 640 by 480, this is already quite some kilobytes of memory. 460 by what? 640 by 480 is 300 kilobytes of memory, and this are already divided by 64K segments. And 4.8 segments, so we multiple times in the middle of filling memory, we always need to switch. And the problem is, it's not only the switching, it's always that each time you access this, you need to check if it's a new page. So I have here VGA set page for this page here, and I store here a static variable, this previous used last page. And only if this differs, I do this expensive I/O port access here to 3CD and 3CB. And even this was strangely documented. It took me a while to understand their strangely worded documentation. And that to use this, I have this commented out here because I test fill here the memory with this pattern. And obviously this did not yet work. So we need to divide this into an offset and a page. And the offset we can just truncate here to an, because this obviously is a 32-bit pointer, so we can just truncate this. This is effectively ending this, but by truncating we don't need to end this with FFFF. So just truncate this, and this is always the stuff that could give you a compiler warning, like casting this with losing precision. If you want to get rid of this compiler warning, you could always just explicitly cast it there additionally. And the page is here the rest that we truncated away there. So we shift this down 16 bits, and then we have this page left over there. And then we call this set page that should probably be inlined. We can also explicitly inline it there, but then for each access we need to compare it there, slightly expensive of course. Maybe it's possible to do some trickery with some overflow curry flag or something, but yeah, really expensive and annoying. Expensive in terms of CPU cycles, obviously. And let's see, I tested this already, and then just for the sake of it, after this, switch back to this. And the problem is that my text functions I have here already last year released here of this VGA glue text splitting, because obviously this card doesn't have its own text splitting there in graphic mode. So we need to blitz these pixels ourselves. And for this, I have this code. However, this is not yet taking care of any banking stuff. It's slow enough as it is. It's relatively coded so that it's kind of readable, but not the most amazing performance. So even there, we would need to have this bank switching in there. So, yeah. So much to that. Then let's... Yeah, but we need to modify this another time in a way, maybe with some macro preprocessor definitions to only include this bank switching if the calling demo application program thing asks for it. And I really wish this would have a chance to work. So probably I need to reverse engineer that even more another day. So bank switching, set page here. Set this remaining offset here. Ah, this needs to be offset then, not I. And maybe leave in the comments below what you like and dislike, what you like to see, what is boring and what is more interesting. And maybe another day we continue with something more modern and also with transferring data in a more elegant way to this vintage environment. But anyway, next is also other stuff. So 11 people watching, that is amazing. Let me wrap up my multimeter already. But this is really sad. You buy something vintage, you think it's awesome vintage, then it has maybe no linear frame buffer support, and also the line drawing is not the most accelerated. And yeah, so much to, in case you think about purchasing some vintage stuff and then you're disappointed that it doesn't do what you was hoping it would be doing. So this is working for the most part, just that we have a line in the middle there that I right now wonder where it came from. As you see before, we had there only this first 64K segment filled. This is because we don't have this linear address stuff working. And now with this bank switching, we use this A00 segment in this old-fashioned way. And there you see why this SVGA old-fashioned stuff was a little bit annoying and cumbersome. Of course, if you're already used to real mode 64K segments, then it's slightly less annoying. But if you got over this 64K addressing, then for sure it's not very convenient. This is still this debug output there of some registers, and this is the accelerator status stuff. And yeah, this line in the middle, by the way, could be some BitBLT. I already run some BitBLT, just that it's not working, as you see. That is also, by the way, that I told you the other day in the beginning of the live stream, I fixed this flickering by waiting for vSync for the vertical retrace. This apparently got rid of this flickering, and Beside from this, these graphic artifacts were not there before. This is probably only because we overwrite this here, I guess, because before I overwrote this something a second ago, we didn't have this spot there. And this line in the middle could be related to BitBLT because we already call some accelerator BitBLT, some block image transfer, just that this is not yet working as it should work. We could comment this out. So for this BitBLT, we call this already ET4K, ET4000, BitBLT, blit, and just with the same parameters, with the same arguments. So we are supposed to BitBLT here from this corner 00 to half of the size. So we are supposed to BitBLT this from here to there, just that this does not yet work. No surprise there, as I was busy fiddling with other stuff. And that is here. You see we program here some memory mapped IO registers, just that I still need to figure out all the details that it really works. And we can comment this out. So just as you saw when you watched all the live streams, the first live stream, I wondered that this positions, all the X positions were bytes, not coordinates. So we need to multiply this with our, oh, wait a second, bits, this is wrong. Actually, maybe this could also explain why this needs to be bytes. Good that we talk about this. Bytes, because bits will be 8 or something. This certainly is not right. This is 1 byte or 2 bytes, so this already explains part of this. There you see how bugs are introduced and why stuff doesn't happen. So we need to, so this is our blit source x and y, width and height, destination x and y, and we need to multiply our x values with our bytes per pixel. This is here some wrapping in for filling a pattern. So if you fill like a nice off-on kind of pattern, dithering pattern of this old-fashioned graphics, this 7 is a special value for no wrap. I could make also symbolic constants for this another day. And here are offsets, so this is source offsets. The offsets are, wait a second, are this even, why do we have here only y offset, or was this y offset? All right, I think so. This is the increment for each scan line. So at the end of each scan line, it is incrementing or adding this to the current position. This is right now, if we would need to overlap reverse copy, we would need to swap the direction. This is why to do reverse copy. Right now, I want that it, or I would be happy if it works at all. So source address is SY stride plus X source destination. Then we need to wait for the acceleration queue to be empty. This is our raster operation. We only want to copy the source. And this is the direction, 1 bit for X and Y. And 0 is, so with either of this X or Y direction, this is then in the backwards direction. X and Y pos here, width and height. I wonder by the, ah yeah, this was not multiplied by bytes, I think, because this is internally using this counter. And then we need to trigger the accelerator to start with writing here. There are 2 bits. There's a bit for restore and resume, and one restores or copies this queue into the internal registers, and the other resumes an acceleration. So we could take a look what happens with this small fix, how this, but I'm Would be surprised if this fixes everything already. There's for sure more bits and pieces not yet correct. But maybe this gives us another slightly different pattern. And then let's see what questions we have in the audience. And maybe call it a day. Christian, indeed, what is I'm interested in seeing coding and the hardware output results at the same time. Welcome the Dense34. Welcome everyone. So yeah, with some modified setup here, this testing would be slightly faster. And it's always the first enablement that takes the longest, ET4K. 4K, I need a second nice keyboard though. This membrane keyboard doesn't cut it. So indeed this pattern changed. So this is for sure definitely our bit build. It's just that it's doing some random nonsense there. And by the way, so this initial, actually I could have switched the camera scene here. Need to get more, other mouse, other trackball. Need to get even more professional here. So this is how the pattern looks now. And as you see here, this pattern changed, but somehow it's not correct, as you see, but it could actually be that we copy there some repetitive pattern from there. Maybe the wrapping is because this is also how this was using pattern fill. If you would want to fill something with some colorful pattern, you would store the pattern somewhere, ideally in off-screen memory. Off-screen memory means, my finger wasn't. So you would store this pattern that you want to fill, some colorful pattern. Imagine some pie chart in Microsoft Office, in PowerPoint 2 in 1995 or something. And you would store this nice gradient pattern somewhere, and of course not here, because right now we copy from here. So you would store your pattern in off-screen memory meaning where it's not visible, like here, starting from where the frame buffer is not currently visible. And then you would use the same bit build operation just with this address of the pattern address. And then you would fill some pie chart just like this, just that right now it's doing something that we were not intended and did not intend to do. We were trying to copy this from here to there, just that it's not doing that. But at least I think the Y position is probably correct, I guess, at least something. And yeah, this is, by the way, the accelerator. So one of those, maybe 36, is the accelerator status. So these bits would tell us if the accelerator is still running. It has some running bit, busy and idle bit and such. And yeah, this is why I'm bit-building here my own tech stuff there. And again, obviously, with the linear frame buffers, it would be more awesome. Right now, we need to switch here every 64K segment. We need to switch this stupid segment bank there in this old-fashioned VGA way. And yeah, so this is doing something. And so this is actually the only thing this, and I'm a little bit disappointed with this, but this is what you get from buying first of a kind ISA bus accelerator stuff here from back in the day, because this operation is actually the only thing this card can accelerate. You program this X, Y, width and height, and then source and destination. And it's only doing this, and it's doing block transfer like this, block transfer from here to here. It is doing pattern fill, just that you would need a pattern then somewhere off screen. And then the operation would still be the same, just for a pattern. If you have a 4x4 or 8x8 pattern or something, you need to set this wrap values, because this wrap values indicate how big your pattern is, because you have a small pattern, and then you use this wrap to wrap in 4 or 8 sized increments. And even the line fill works like this. So you can draw a line, and you have seen this already. I showed this in the very first live stream that Brisenham lines. And as I showed already in the very first live stream, that line acceleration on this card is working. Wrong surface. I wanted this. So I said in the very first video when I unpacked this or something, any line drawing using Bresenham algorithm is made up of smaller line segments which are all horizontal, all vertical, or all diagonal. So this is the only thing this can accelerate, and it is done exactly the same way, just that you program not a huge area to fill, but just a 1 pixel area, and then you fill 1 pixel stripe of line segment one by one, and that is how you do this. So yeah, I need to figure out the last bits. You see the accelerator starts to do something, and I'm slightly disappointed that we don't have this linear frame buffer. That is really a pity, in my opinion. Wish it would do this, but currently it doesn't. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little vintage tinkering. I will probably not live stream too many live streams with the same topic, so the next time I might do a video showing the 10-minute rundown of this and not more 1 hour of bit fiddling in there, unless people want to watch it while I have it running here and live stream here 2 hours of trial and error. As usual, let's see what's going on in the comments. And yeah, I'm a noob coder in safe training. Thanks for the stream. You're welcome. And yeah, hope you learned something. Hope you enjoyed it. Again, the point of this was one of the very first ISA accelerators. And yeah, here in this 386 with 486 upgrade in there, I made a video about this. If you want to watch this, actually, that video was because this has still the AMR. I should switch the camera view. This has still the AMD 386 on there, the DX40, and the upgrade CPU is in here, the Intel DX266, so quite some upgrade. This video was watched quite a bit, actually. Really nice to see, even a month or two later, some thousands views or something. Really nice to see these old videos where you see things that you otherwise don't see very often. And yeah, I could actually, theoretically, maybe continue here a little bit more if you wanted to, but otherwise, maybe I read you once, maybe I stop my recording so the archived